Hey guys, what's up? So I have been trying out a new custom ROM on my Redmi Note 6 Pro few days now, and this time we have Lineage OS 21 based on Android 14. So this is an unofficial ROM, and as you guys know, I'm not really a big fan of Lineage OS because Lineage OS doesn't come with any kind of features, and also it is not really a better ROM than other custom ROM, which offers tons of feature, and also they offer pretty good stability than Lineage OS. So that's why I don't really like. And also this ROM is unofficial, so I'm not really into it. But anyway, let's explore this ROM together. So first of all, we'll check the Android version and security patch level as I always do. So as you can see here, Android version 14 and the security patch level is 5th of April 2024, so pretty recent build. And going back, the setting layout is pretty much typical to the Android 14 based ROM, so there is nothing new here. Everything is pretty much similar in terms of Wi-Fi and hotspot, both of them working. SIM card is working, phone call is working just fine. I had issue with Bluetooth actually, so Bluetooth has some issue in this ROM, and when I was trying to share some file from this device to another device by Bluetooth, it did not work. And also, Quick Share doesn't work on this ROM for some reason. But maybe it could be Quick Share uses Bluetooth to transfer data. So because of that, maybe it is not working. So anyway, Bluetooth and Quick Share is not working on this ROM for some reason. Bluetooth does turn on actually, and it does find the Bluetooth. But for some reason, I cannot send any kind of pictures or anything like that to another device. In terms of battery, the battery is doing pretty good actually. There is fast charging disable option, and also you are getting charging control, and you can choose limit charging or custom schedule. So you can do those things, and also you can do automatic schedule, which will manage to like charge your device automatically whenever you put it in charge. It will decide automatically. In terms of storage, 52 GB is available as you can see here. I did not install anything here actually. Maybe two or three applications. Those are not really that big. In terms of sound and vibration, it's working perfectly fine, no issue. Display section, so adaptive brightness and all other things are working perfectly fine, no issue. But if you go to wallpaper and style, we are not getting any kind of AI wallpaper option here. And also in the clock and size option, we are not getting any kind of clock option too here. I don't really know why those are not included in Android 14 based ROM. So those are not there. And going back, the security and privacy option, we don't really have any face unlock here. But the fingerprint unlock is working perfectly fine, no issue with that. It works most of the time. Sometimes you will see some issue with the fingerprint, like it will not register. Sometimes you have to enroll two or three times, but usually it works, no issue with that. There is a location option which does work perfectly fine. In the system option, if you go to button section, if you use on-screen navigation buttons, you will find some extra features for those things. But rather than that, there is nothing extra actually in this ROM. And also, we do have gesture option, which is working perfectly fine, no issue. Going back in the setting, there is nothing much actually. So, in terms of application, this ROM did not come with GApps. So, if you are flashing this ROM, you have to flash GApps separately. And after flashing GApps is working perfectly fine, no issue. And safety net doesn't work, so you cannot use bank apps on this ROM. As you can see, failed. And there are a few applications. The phone application is actually not the Google one. The messaging application is also not Google one. But in terms of camera, we are getting one camera application here, which does work. This is Gcam Go maybe, and it works perfectly fine, no issue with that. And if you want proper Gcam, you can install and it will work flawlessly, no issue with camera. Rather than that, there is nothing new or nothing to talk about. The ROM is working perfectly fine. Only issue is with the Bluetooth and with the Quick Share. Rather than that, the ROM is pretty much smooth, although it is an unofficial ROM. I did not find any kind of issue. regarding this ROM. The ROM link will be in the description below. If you want to try it out, you can try it out. Performance is really good, actually. It's not really that bad. But I would prefer Evolution X over this ROM because that ROM offers tons of feature. We are getting MIUI camera and everything works flawlessly on that ROM. So that's all about Lineage OS 21 for Redmi Note 6 Pro. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next one.